It's Wednesday, May 2nd, guys. Thank you for tuning in. What I'm going to cover in this video is basically just the T-Mobile quarter one earnings, so it'll be a quick one. Let's just start off with total revenue. So for total revenue, they're at $10.46 billion. This is about $7.8 billion in service revenue. In quarter one 2017, this was $9.61 billion, and in quarter four of 2017, this was $10.76 billion. So in terms of, you know, last quarter, it is down just a smidge. Nothing too crazy, but the expectation was $10.35 billion, so they did exceed their expectation. Total net adds, in terms of customers, 1.4 million new subs. In terms of the breakdown of that, it's 617,000 postpaid adds, 200,000 prepaid adds. I believe the number was actually 199,000, so those are good adds there, definitely very good. In terms of earnings, earnings are down about 2.5% same time this time last year. But this is the 20th consecutive quarter with a million or more customer adds. Churn rate is also at a record low. It's down to about 1.07%. So people are sticking around and staying with T-Mobile. This is definitely their best quarter in that statistic. Last year, I believe, at this time, so quarter one 2017, it was 1.18% of a churn. Now, their goal was to have a 2 to 3 million customer base in terms of their ads for the year. This is interesting because if previously the trend was 2 to 3 million per year, they want to actually set a goal for 2.6 to 3.3 million. So they are kind of bumping it up about 20 to 35%, just depending on you know, what comes out of that. But they do want to see an increase there. So this is definitely a solid quarter for T-Mobile. In terms of all measurables, with the exception of the revenue and the earnings, it's down about 2.5%. Now, you could probably find blame in the competition. You know, market promos are starting to dissolve a little bit. This should definitely correct itself in quarter two. I think their earnings are going to, you know, spike back up and kind of go back to normalcy. In terms of the total quarter, I think it's positive. I think the merger also, you know, with that news, along with the positivity, the vibes, the optimism around the company, this is really good for T-Mobile. My prediction for quarter two, I think it's going to be similar in all the measurables, with the exception that I think the earnings are going to stabilize. I think they're going to continue to add another one or more million postpaid adds. You know, this is now 20 consecutive quarters with, you know, 1 million or more ads. So I think that's going to continue. T-Mobile's hot, and it's definitely a trend that is not going to stop. What I want to hear from you guys is, what do you think of the quarter one from T-Mobile? And, you know, what do you think quarter two is going to bring for them? So let me know your thoughts and opinions in the comment section below. Also, if you're interested in a deal, maybe you're on Verizon or thinking about switching, the Google Pixel 2 XL, not sure if it covers the regular Pixel 2, the smaller model, but Best Buy's got an instant rebate of $200 off. You get it, you know, right at the time of you buying the device. And Verizon is going to give you $300 in credits, which will be, you know, off the monthly installments. So I believe the credits will be $12.50 off per month. So this will put the total cost of the phone at $350. A great deal if you're looking to upgrade or get that device. So that's it for this one, guys. Thank you guys for watching. Much appreciated. Please like the video, share the video, subscribe if you haven't done so already. Have a great day. This is Steve from C-Mobile Tech, and I'll see you on the next video.